Hey everyone, a very good morning to all of you. Myself, Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. Let's begin today's video, but before that, you need to know that this PDF is downloadable. The link is in description below. So the very first question is, which command of the Indian Navy pioneered Joint Maritime Exercise Paschim Leher 2022? So guys, here the right answer is option C, Western Naval Command is the pioneer of this Joint Maritime Exercise. Now it is a Joint Maritime Exercise, so the other party that is participating in this exercise is the Indian Coast Guard. So it is India's indigenous exercise taking place between the Indian Navy and the Indian Coast Guard. Now the wing of the Indian Navy that is participating and pioneering this exercise is the Western Naval Command. So this clearly gives us the venue as well, indicates the venue of this exercise as well, which is the Arabian Sea. Okay, now apart from this, you need not to memorize any other information related to exercise Paschim Leher. Moving ahead, where is India's Innovation Center for Graphene established? So the right answer here is Thrissur. So basically, the Ministry of Electronics and IT has given its approval to establish the India Innovation Center for Graphene. Right now, it has not been established. It is the approval given by the Ministry of Electronics and IT. So first of all, you need to know that it is the first ever center for graphene in India. So this center will basically research and will research on the industry level applications of graphene. Basically, how can India use graphene in the industry? What is the application of graphene in the industries? That will be researched, and the measures to use the graphene in the industries will be developed at this India Innovation Center for Graphene, which will be established in Thrissur, Kerala. Okay, now graphene, what is graphene? So graphene is basically a matter which is developed of carbon. So this is something that you need to understand as far as graphene is concerned. Don't go into the depth of graphene because that is not necessary from our exam point of view as well. Now graphene has a lot of uses. So it is used in fuel cells, it is used in wearable devices as well, electronic wearable devices as well, it is used in semiconductors. So it has a wide range of uses. Therefore, this center has been established by the Ministry of Electronics and IT. Now, the other fact from this center that you need to know is that three main organizations are partnering to establish this center. So it is a joint venture. So which three organizations are these? First is the Center for Materials for Electronics Technology based in Pune, Digital University Kerala, Tata Steel Limited. Now there are other organizations as well that are participant in this center, but the three main organizations are these only. So you need to restrict yourselves to these three organizations only. Okay. So now here guys, the application of graphene is given, that graphene is used in electronic wearable devices, biomedical devices, sensors, fuel cells, semiconductor, field emission displays, nano electrodes, etc. etc. Now graphene is also a good conductor of electricity and it is very flexible also. Now another application of graphene is that graphene coating on machines or the iron can prevent the factories and industries from incurring losses due to corrosion. So graphene coating is a good measure to prevent corrosion as well. So this is clearly you can see that this is all an extra information. So don't cram this information in your mind. You just need to know that graphene is basically a matter that is made up of carbon. Okay, and it has a wide use in industries. Therefore, this center has been established. Moving ahead, so the third question is, which of the following organizations has developed the first ever climate hazard and vulnerability atlas of India? So here the right answer is Climate Research and Services. So guys, this is basically a wing of IMD, India Meteorological Department. And let me tell you that this is the first ever Climate Hazard and Vulnerability Atlas of India, which is going to tell you about the hazards that are there, hazard prone areas and the types of hazards which are there and what would be the impact of the hazard on the people as well as their livelihood. So this is all that will be provided via this atlas. Now how many types of disasters are covered by this atlas? So here the right answer is 14. So guys, this can also become a question for you because this is the first ever climate hazard and vulnerability atlas of India. So first ever hai, that's why they can ask you the number of disasters that are covered by this atlas as well. So do remember it is 14. Now all the things that I have told you here via the word of mouth are written here as well. So you can revise it continuously when you will get the PDF so that you can retain it till the examination period. How many Doppler weather radars are operational in India? So here guys, option B, 33 Doppler weather radars are operational in India, because recently 4 new Doppler weather radars were established by the Ministry of Earth Sciences. And with the addition of those 4 new Doppler weather radars, the number of Doppler weather radars which are operational in India reached 33. Okay, so this is the recent news. Now, what is the Doppler weather radar? Because this is a really important, we can say, equipment for farming as well. Because the Doppler weather radars basically study the precipitation in the atmosphere. And precipitation basically is the coming down of the rainfall or the hailstorm or the snow. So whichever it is, the amount of evaporated vapors that comes down on earth is precipitation. Okay, be it in the form of rainfall, be it in the form of snow, be it in the form of hailstorm. So, what is the first unit that comes down on earth? It's a drop, be it a drop of rainfall, be it a ball of snowball, so snowfall, it's just a drop. So, from the drop word, you can remember that Doppler weather radars study the precipitation in the atmosphere. Okay, drop and Doppler, both of them seem analogous to each other, therefore it would be easier for you to memorize it that Doppler weather radars are used for studying the precipitation. And we know that Indian agriculture system is majorly dependent on rainfall, therefore they hold a really very significant place in the Indian agriculture arena as well. Okay. Now guys, so the purpose I have already told you. So first Doppler weather radar system was established in Leh, and do remember that this is the highest altitude where this Doppler weather radar system has been established in India, at Leh. Next is, second one was in Delhi, and for Delhi itself, it's the third Doppler radar. So now Delhi has 3 Doppler radar systems. Third one is in Mumbai, fourth one is in Chennai. Okay, now here you can see C band, X band. Okay, this is guys, superfluous information that you can clearly ignore at this moment of time, because you need not to cram your mind with these many minute details. Okay. Just do remember that the Leh one is the highest altitude Doppler weather radar. Then Delhi has got the third Doppler radar with the addition of this new one, and Mumbai has got its second radar, and the last one radar was in Chennai. Now with these 33 operational radars are there. Guys, an application named Public Observation is already there, developed by IMD, and the purpose of this is to allow the citizens to inform IMD about the weather situations in their area. So this kind of application is really useful for the remotest parts of the country where the radars, where the Doppler weather radars are not established, and the other instruments or technologies is really hard to be established in the remotest areas. So there the citizens themselves can inform the IMD about the weather conditions, and this will also help in citizens participation at a greater scale. Okay, so when citizens will be participating in providing the information about the weather situation in their locality, then they will also be basically at a very basic level, at a very minimal level, but still an awareness about the weather is created among the rural people, among the remotest areas people. And what IMD is doing for resolving that situation, for helping the people, helping in correcting the situation, that is also the citizens get aware about through this application. Okay, Next is, which company has developed Power Map, which is India's first intelligent chronic disease patients habit tracking system? So here right answer is option C, Madhav Bog. So guys, this is basically a medical services institution. This is a kind of institution, a kind of hospital institution that provides the medical services to the chronic patients. Now this institution provides the treatment to the people by using the Ayurvedic technologies, basically Ayurvedic techniques as well as new modern age technologies. So it is a really good amalgamation of the modern day technology with the Ayurvedic traditional methods, and by using both of these, chronic ailments like diabetes, like cardiac ailments, etc., the diseases which are chronic in nature, hypertension, so all of these diseases are cured in this Madhav Bog. Now it has developed this Power Map, which is basically a tracking system to track the habits of the chronic ailment patients in order to understand their behavior patterns, and if the behavior patterns of humans are decoded, then obviously this will help the organization to create the medical structure according to their needs. So that's the need of this India's first intelligent chronic disease patient habit tracking system, which is named as Power Map, and it is developed by an organization named Madhav Bog. Next is, when was the cyber security program launched? Sorry, cyber surakshit program launched. So it was launched in 2018. So it is basically a program of Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology, and the basic purpose of this program was to acquaint the government level officials, both at the center and state level, the PSU, the banks, so every personnel that is there in the government organization, they will be acquainted with the cyber security measures as well as the kind of cyber attacks that they can confront at the organization level. Okay, so in order to acquaint them with the cyber security measures as well as acquaint them with the cyber threats, the Cyber Surakshit program was launched in 2018. Now, how are they acquainting them? I have told you the why part of this program, that why was this launched and when was this launched, but how are they going to provide the training to the personnel? That is through the training programs, and those training programs are known as deep dive training programs. Okay, so deep dive training program is the name of the program that is organized under this cyber suraksha program. Recently, 26th edition of this program was organized, and it was organized by the CISO, that is Chief Information Security Officers Organization. And basically, the purpose is to acquaint the participants with the best practices in the cyber security field. Next question is, who has been appointed as the chairman of the Apparel Export Promotion Council? So guys, here the right answer is option A, Narendra Goenka. Last question is, who has won the best FIFA Men's Player Award? So it is Robert Lewandowski who has won this award. Guys, FIFA president Gianni Infantino, can you guys tell me which country does he belong to? So he has announced the best FIFA football awards. The men's awards has been won by the Robert Lewandowski from Poland. Women's award has been won by Alexia Putellas from Spain. Then men's coach, women's coach, men's goalkeeper, women's goalkeeper, FIFA fan award. Okay, do remember the FIFA fan award has been given to Denmark and Finland's fans of football. Then FIFA Puskas Award, this is also another unique category, we can say, although it is not the first time that Puskas Award has been given by FIFA, but it stands apart from the crowd, so that is why I told you that it is a unique category. Then FIFA Special Best Men's Award, which has been given to Cristiano Ronaldo. So guys, all the awards that I have ticked here are of the most importance, so do remember those awards, but I did not tell you to ignore the other awards. Okay, men's coach, women's coach, men's goalkeeper, women's goalkeeper are really important because football is one sport that is really, really famous at international level, although India in India the popularity of football is not of much is not of a very great scale, but still At the international level, football is a really good sport that has a high popularity. Therefore, all the categories of awards are important and they can be asked from you. And the headquarters of FIFA, also remember this, that it is in Zurich, Switzerland, and here only all these awards were given to the winners. So guys, here I would like to end today's session. Thank you so much for watching this video, and if you really liked the content provided by us, then do not forget to subscribe the channel and hit the bell notification. At the same time, you can like this video, share it among your friends as well. Thank you so much for watching the video.